When I was a child, I could shut my eyes and get in touch with the forces of destiny. It made wonderful things happen.
What sort of things?
Well, a perfectly beastly nanny got a mysterious complaint and had to be sent away. They said it was the second gardener, but I knew it was the forces of destiny. They're extremely strong once you get in touch with them.
I think you'd better open your eyes. No, but the studges are.
Do you want one? Might as well.
Ich möchte...
That one bitter.
Pizza?
Yeah.
Mit Sahne?
Mm-hmm.
That's the trouble with Fridays. Waiting for him with far too many schnackles.
Mehr?
Oh well, noch ein Fund, for God's sake.
Guten Appetit, Fräulein.
Danke schön.
You.
Eating cream cakes and waiting for him all this time. It's a supreme sacrifice.
I don't think that's funny at all.
He's looking at us. An absolutely marvellous storm. Do you know him?
He's not a storm, he's an SS.
And anyone could know him, anyone.
However long are you going to wait here?
However long it takes.
The Mitford girl, sir. She was wearing that confounded badge.
No. No, Philip, I don't know. What badge? The brownies, the froth blowers, the gudnunks? Suppose you tell me.
She was wearing the BUF badge, sir.
BUF?
Yes.
It's what I find so terribly difficult about the new consular intake. You speak entirely in code. Couldn't we have it in clear?
But, yes, I'm sorry.
Philip, yeah. You've got your MP fella for dinner tonight, Hillary. Kraut or frog cooking?
Oh, Sir Arnold Latimer. Oh, Kraut, I think. Pillar of the Anglo-German Friendship Society. Blutwurst and the full lot.
Oh, I draw the line at Blutwurst. We'll give them a nice joint of really bloody roast beef.
Splendid, my dear.
With Yorkshire pudding.
You were saying, Philip.
Yes. Just make sure the kitchens don't put a dollop of whipped cream on the top.
The British Union of Fascists badge, sir. An English girl sits in their favourite restaurant wearing a fascist badge.
Philip, do you remember Alice in Wonderland? It's about the only book that can be of the slightest help to you in the British Consular Service. She only does it to annoy, because she knows it teases.
Yes, sir, but who does she do it to annoy, sir?
Probably you and me, Philip. People exactly like us.
Ich wünschte, mein Vater käme. Please, girls, note the use of the subjunctive mood. Repeat.
Ich wünsche, mein Vater käme bald.
I wish my father would come soon. Again.
Ich wünsche, mein Vater käme bald.
Thank you. Ich wünschte, Fräulein Baum wäre meine Lehrerin.
Ich wünschte, Fräulein Baum wäre meine Lehrerin.
I wish Miss Baum were my schoolteacher. Now, what is wrong with that? I will tell you what is wrong with that. I am not your schoolteacher. I am your pal. And pals learn from each other. Is that not so? You will learn from me all about Germany, and I will learn from you all about England. So the greatest two people in this world will learn from each other. Is that not so? Now then, would you like to know how I came to love England? I shall let you into the secret. I have had an English Geliebte.
Geliebte?
Now you all know what Geliebte is, even though you have not one of your own yet. The war came. It was most sad. Mein Geliebte died in your army, fighting our army. And so, our love was born in battle, in Krieg.
In Krieg.
Our friendship was forged in blood and steel, Blut und Stahl. Girls, I want you to write those words down. I want you to learn them for your vocabulary. Blut und Stahl. Blut und Stahl. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa! May I have your attention, please? Whoa, whoa, whoa! Which dog do we resemble most? My Eric told me that all English girls look like little spaniels with sad, obedient eyes. I myself, for reason of the long nose and the small paws, resemble the dachshund. Is that not so? Has that thought occurred to any of you? In fact, my pet name is Duxy. You may call me by my pet name, but only under one condition. That you call me Duxy to my face. Is that quite understood? You are not to use my nickname behind my back. Let us all be open and honest German and English ladies. Don't become secretive and backbiting like the Jews.
The number of broken windows Arnold and I have seen in Munich.
Those young lads of the Brown Shirt Brigade must be giving a great deal of employment to the manufacturers of plate glass.
Oh, Lady Latimer, I suppose that is one way of looking at it.
The high-spirited. The young are high-spirited, aren't they, my boy? When I think of what we used to get up to on boat race night.
Same with you, was it, at Trinity?
No. You can't blame their leader for a bit of youthful high spirit.
Can't you?
There's a very drinkable glass of Margot. One can still get a decent claret here, thank heavens.
Oh, excellent. Yeah, and even if the leader's followers have been guilty of what we might think of, speaking as outsiders, as crimes against their own people, that's a purely domestic matter, wouldn't you agree?
Yeah, that was to be under purely domestic.
What would you like to see while you're here, Sir Arnold?
Well, I think the House of Commons will be anxious to hear about the achievements of the German government. There's been so much misleading propaganda.
Mm. We should know the truth.
The roads, for instance. Now, motoring has become a positive pleasure.
The maternity clinic.
What's been done for the young people? That's what impresses me.
And morality.
Morality?
I understand Munich was notorious at one time for houses of ill repute.
When I was number two in Murmansk, we heard rumours to that effect. I never managed to arrange a transfer, however.
Well, that's been changed at least.
Yes, indeed, Lady Latimer. They have now a rather different notion of strength through joy.
And a rather healthier one.
Oh, yes, yes. They built a new heaven and a new earth, where one may drive in comfort along the smoothest tar macadam until you reach a youth centre made of concrete, where you can eat cream cakes, listen to the merry widow waltz without ever having a political argument. One is bound to agree that a brave new world like that is worth a great deal of sacrifice.
Oh, but I look at it. Brown shirts are simply the children of the Conservatives. Surely there can't be any real difference between us.
When I was last in London, sir, I don't remember seeing the Conservatives smashing the windows of the local pawn shops. At least not while your local Bobby stood by watching.
Pawn shops? That's the way they make a fortune.
Who makes a fortune, exactly?
Well, a pawnbroker's.
Well, let's face up to it, that class of person has made himself pretty unpopular here. After all, you always manage to end up with the best cut off the joint when your ordinary man in the street was going hungry after the war, you know what I mean?
I wonder if I might be excused. I've got a terrible amount of paperwork to do.
No, sir, you can stay here. You'll find listening to Sir Arnold Latimer a wonderful lesson in diplomacy.
Huh?
Ah.
Some get a kick from cocaine. I'm sure that is...
Nearly ready for bed, girl? Everybody happy and contented in here? Painting toenails, Fräulein Annie. Not quite the action of a young lady of Nordic origins.
Oh, you'd be surprised, Boynton. Annie and I have been invited to stay with the Almishes. There'll be hardly a white toenail around Castle Bernstein. All really posh Nords paint their toenails green. Then perhaps you wouldn't know about the best Nords, would you, Daxie?
Well... If you're going to Schloss Bernstein tomorrow, I suggest you go to sleep now.
Oh, we don't sleep. It's terribly non-Nordic to sleep.
I shall go to bed in any case. Good night. Good enough. Slapper.
Good enough.
You give poor old Daxie a rough time, don't you?
Well, she's a governess. I know exactly how to deal with governesses.
Oh, really? What's the secret?
Stare them out. I used to stare new ones out at nursery tea. Governesses are a lot like lions. They can't stand the human eye. And then if that didn't work, I'd introduce them to Enid.
Who was Enid? Another sister?
My snake. One governess fainted when she found Enid coiled round the loo chain. Came down with an enormous crash. Miss Parson, she was huge and objectionable.
Where on earth did you get her from? Enid, I mean.
The pet department at Harrods. Mum and Fab didn't approve of schools, you see, so I had to work my will on governesses.
Must have been a bit lonely.
What?
Not going to school?
No, not really. I wasn't really lonely, sitting in the linen cupboard with the sisters, singing our national anthem.
Your what?
Our national anthem.
We got the words from a wonderful, disastrous headline in Cook's Daily Mirror. Man's long agony in a lift shaft, slowly crushed to death by lift. When we sang that, it used to make my younger sister pipe.
Pipe?
Pipe her eye. Floods the tears.
Fab used to dock her pocket money.
Her pocket money?
Oh, yes. Fab was dead against crying, especially if you were a girl. It's the colour of his eyes that's so wonderful.
Your father's?
Don't be ridiculous. It's the colour that you never get from a photograph. Wonderful blue eyes.
Welcome to the Enchanted Castle.
Janosch, Annie MacFarlane.
How do you do, my dear? Now, my dear, I can understand so many things about you.
Janosch, can your wretched horoscopes really influence the future?
If I take your birth date, your natal sign shows great consistency. You cannot compromise.
What else?
There is a man, of course.
White dragon.
Powerful influence. Force.
Come on. Your turn.
I very much regret it.
What?
This powerful masculine influence doesn't appear to be me.
Wer ist sie eigentlich?
Mitford.
Eine der Töchter von Reedsdale.
Natürlich. Lord Reedsdale.
Nach dem Abendessen hat sie uns mit Politik gelangweilt. Sie redet dauernd von ihrem Schwager.
Eben. Sir Oswald
Mosley. Er ist offenbar Anführer der englischen Faschisten.
Englische Faschisten? Eine unverdauliche Mischung. Like rice pudding mit Spaghetti.
Mein Mann glaubt, er ist in sie verliebt.
Virgo and Mars, in your quarter of the heavens, a most extraordinary conjunction. Your destiny will be to bring peoples together.
Hallo.
Lady Mitford? Lady Mitford?
Yes?
Hanfstengel! Public relations of the Foreign Office. We never had a chance to chat at dinner.
Putsy, putsy. You are interrupting our chat with the stars.
Oh, roll up your charts, my dear Janosch. Lady Mitford does not need the stars. She can manage quite well by herself. Tell me, Lady Mitford, are the daffodils still just as beautiful in your parents' place in Spencer?
You know Swinbrook.
Now, I am simply a prisoner of the Foreign Office, but how I long to be in your country. Oh, to be in England now that April is there. Robert Browning, I think. England in the springtime when the daffodils are out, Vermont in the fall. Where else could a civilized German wish to be?
In Paris by Christmas.
Really, my dear Janosch, you are so mean. But I hear so much news of your family from Edmund Spurbright. You know Lord Spurbright, of course.
No, not really.
Such a terrible snob. The last time I was in Ditchling, I heard him say of Charlie Fortinbras, that family really is most terrifically nouveau. They only came over with the conquest. Came over with the conquest. Breathtaking, isn't it? Your wonderful history. Janosch. My is so sad this evening. Why don't you go and give her some good news about the stars? Tell her that the danger of Venus entering her orbit is past. You like music, Lady Mitford?
Some music.
You shall hear me play Wagner. Can you imagine what are the happiest moments of our leader?
Our leader? No.
When I am playing for him the piano, his beloved Liebestod from Tristan. When I play this, it brings tears to his eyes. Always. He is a sensitive man. Sadly, there are those who do not understand such sensitivity.
You know the leader?
Oh, I have been with him since the early meetings in the Beer Kelle in Munich. I have taught him to understand the world of music. Come, you shall hear.
Come! Lady Mitford, we have achieved our first aim. We have power. But what is power without civilization? What do they think we are in the salons of Paris and London, in the drawing rooms of Park Avenue? Do they think we are barbarians? Do they mistake us ever for Attila the Hun?
People are simply ignorant.
You are so right, Lady Mitford. People are so lumpen, so deaf to music. But in every country, in Germany, in America, in England, there are some who can be rare spirits, young people, people from the best families. These people know the secrets of art.
Help
from those same rare spirits. he is to leave behind the beer keller and put on the crown of Charlemagne. That is why I play to him this music of spiritual love as often as possible. With this music, I try to drown the belching of his old cronies, the natural representatives of the lumpen. As I was telling old Billy Dodd, the American ambassador, during the war I worked in California with many film producers, and such film producers were far more tyrannical than our leader, and far less understanding of the world of art. I must be with our leader. We visit Augsburg together. Lady Mitford. We shall meet again.
Yes. I forget your name.
Collindale, Philip.
Collindale.
The British consulate.
Isn't that a place on the tube or something? I'm sure I read it in the Daily Mirror. Carnage in Collindale. Two legs severed in Chewfora, that sort of thing. Have you noticed that legs always get severed in the Mirror? In the Times, they simply get mislaid. Did you come in a car or something?
A sort of car.
Ah,
yeah.
Wunderbar, you can drive me back tomorrow. I'd like to start early and go on the Augsburg Road. Yeah. Such a lovely party. Thank you for having me. I'm afraid I have to leave early in the morning, so auf Wiedersehen.
Do come again, my dear. For some reason, my husband seems to find you beautiful.
Enchanted castle, full of spirits and magicians and giants, just like Germany.
There are other things in Germany, unfortunately, apart from fairy stories.
Did you say you went to Cambridge? I do believe you're about to become achingly dull.
For instance, what a magical place for a Jew.
What do you mean? Of course they're perfectly right about the Jews. We should have had the courage to do that long ago in England.
Just the sort of
and
remark.
And take that po-faced British look off your face. Can't you do more than an utterly wet 30 miles an hour?
Not without exploding.
Go on, explode then. Make him fall off his bike.
No.
Go on, it's easy, I'll show you how. I'm
Pull into the side and stop the car. Wonderful, cruel eyes of the sweet Mac. Why didn't you salute?
Well, wouldn't have been very diplomatic, would it?
But you wanted to, though, didn't you? As he went by, couldn't you feel your arm moving, the nerves tightening, so it was moving by itself? You felt that. Go on, be honest. You can't be honest, can you? You can only be diplomatic.
You were invited.
Couldn't oblige. Entertaining, throwing a party at Fräulein Dexel's Academy. Remind me, did I invite you?
Yes, as a matter of fact.
I must be in your car. Everyone! This is... a bit of Cambridge wet, but he has got a muffin! Now, who shall I introduce you to? Bachelor.
Hello, how do you do?
It's a super SS called Max. Max.
Leutgeb.
Leutgeb. This is Bachelor. Surprise, surprise. He's a rat.
And not even Jewish.
Tony Albertini. My father would describe as an arch sewer. God knows how he got in.
Flew in through the nursery window. I'm one of the Lost Boys.
How do you do?
Tony's friend, Lothar.
We've got...
You know Annie McFarlane?
Annie.
Philip.
Hello.
This is Julia Owen Fillmore.
Hello, Julia.
Sylvia
Hello.
Courtney Hello. Brown. Petra Plowright. Dee Dee Slingsby. Rebel the well-known one. And Unity Valkyrie Mitford. Well, there you have it. Meine Lieben, may I present Philip... Collindale. You are one of the London Underground, Collindale.
No, we did that, of course. As a matter of fact, we all come from Yorkshire.
A country boy.
You're in the consulate?
Yes.
Then you have to help explain it all to the ignorant English.
Explain all what exactly?
The Germans and us. The German army and the English navy and our two air forces, we are going to rule all the other races.
But I'm not sure I agree with all that.
Then we'll have to send you off to Dachau, won't we? Philip, want another drink?
Yes, thank you very much.
There you are.
Our hostess's works of art. Be terribly honest now, do they remind you of the works of William Blake?
Just a little, I suppose. Yes.
And is it been how Blake would have painted if Blake couldn't paint? Songs of innocence and experience. With our hostess, they're songs of innocence only. She has absolutely no experience of any sort. Unlike her sister and that bully boy husband of hers. You should remember that if you're after her.
Why should I be after her?
You came here, didn't you?
I came here because she asked me to.
That's absolutely no reason for coming.
Why on earth are you here then?
Well, to be absolutely honest with you, my dear, I came here to meet the youth movement. Well, if you'd been brought up like I was in the wastes of Bournemouth, you'd be a sucker for anything in uniform. And our hostess has given me a few little introductions. That impertinent little brown shirt Lothar there. Weren't you absolutely swept away by his eyelashes?
Hello?
Hello. Not exactly.
Oh, I am. But then I'm deeply impressionable. I can't say I feel much for the one with the glasses. Oh. Or the Max bus. But the little Lothar, he plays an absolute pizzicato on my heartstrings.
Unity! Paul and Baum said yesterday.
Des l'erreur.
We've been bicycling for miles.
God, we bicycle everywhere. Round
the bend to the art gallery and out into the forest. Anyway, we were parched. Thirsty, terribly thirsty. Our tongues were hanging out when we got back and we were begging for lemonade. And do you know what the Duxham said? Pull yourselves together, girls. It's terribly Jewish to be thirsty.
The lady doth protest too much, methinks.
What on earth do you mean?
I'm not going on about Jews like that. Makes you wonder whether she might have something to hide. Oh, come on, everyone. This is a terribly dull little party.
Oh, is she serious?
I beg your pardon, I was lost in Lothar's eyelashes.
I mean, the way she talks about the Jews.
I don't think she's ever really met a Jew. She's serious, all right. That's her trouble. She's deadly serious.
Come on, you hold on.
Oh, don't stop.
Now I am cross. I am really cross. I have so few rules and regulations here. You are free. You are free like in a happy family. But no food in rooms. And no gramophone music. And no men after 10 p.m. Your mother trusts me. What would she say if I told her that you're up until all hours, eating loofahs, entertaining soldiers, and playing loud music?
Juden sind hier nicht erwünscht.
What did you say to me?
Jews are not welcome here, Fräulein. Tot allen Juden.
God help me, it is fast. Pardon me?
Terrible, they're coming.
Who's coming?
T-P-O-M. The poor old male, Favre, my father, who art in Springbrook, coming here to the Arbor Hotel.
Is the poor old female coming with him?
Undoubtedly, he never goes far without her. She won't understand. Favre might be a bit easier. As a matter of fact, he's one of nature's fascists. Oh, but if only they could have waited, Dan.
Well, can't you put them off?
My parents, of course not. They come inevitably, like the curse. Only they could have waited. As it is, they want to go to the art gallery, to the opera, out of the Starnberg Zay, have a long chat with old Boynkin about how my German grammar's getting on. It's all time completely wasted.
You've waited here very patiently.
Dr. Hemstein.
Oh, please, Putzi to all my friends.
You know Annie McFarlane?
Oh, but of course, I've played golf with your father, St. Andrews, quite a charming old boy. You permit me?
Please.
Lady Mitford, I believe your patience may be rewarded.
What do you mean?
I've told you of my dream, and I'm sure that you share it. Select people from every country. If the world did not have such an unfortunate association, I might call it so. The chosen will come together to create a new civilization. There will be a meeting. Shall we call it a meeting of the minds? Here in this old restaurant, the Osteria Bavaria.
Well, we have been waiting here, you're quite right, for hours every Friday.
You have been patient, I know. Patient and devoted, waiting for us. And now we have struggled up to the top of the mountain to meet you. That's why I say to Anita, perhaps it is time for us to enjoy La Douceur. May I make a suggestion? A little less of the maquillage. Health through joy, sweet simplicity of the Aryan woman, Kinder, Kirche, Küche, that sort of thing. I am not absolutely bound to it myself, but it is, as you know, official policy. Cosmetics, high heels, fur coats, lap dogs remind us of the mistresses of international Jewry. We are still tied, I must say, to my regret, to somewhat primitive images. I will ask you, remove the lipstick. And now I think perhaps you are ready to play your small
Der Führer wünscht, dass Sie an seinen Tisch kommen. Nur Sie, mein Fräulein.
Jewish families cannot live together creatively.
Auf Deutsch gesagt, die jüdischen Behausungen sind unsauber und verwahrlost.
Jewish houses are dirty and neglected.
Man muss bedenken, dass diese Juden nicht etwa arm sind.
These Jews are not poor.
Durch jahrzehntelangen Handel haben sie genug Geld
angehäuft,
um sich und ihrer Familie ein sauberes und behagliches Heim zu schaffen.
Buy themselves clean and comfortable homes.
Wir erkennen, dass hier ein Pestherd liegt.
Undoubtedly the Jews are a
plague
that threatens Aryan family life.
Richard Wagner hat einmal gesagt,
Richard Wagner
der Jude
said,
ist der plastische Dämon des Verfalls der
the Jew is responsible for the decline of the human race.
Die Bilder bestätigen die Richtigkeit seines Ausspruchs.
How right he was.
Wo Ratten auch auftauchen, tragen sie Vernichtung ins Land. Zerstören sie menschliche Güter
they scavenge
und
in people's larders.
Auf diese Weise verbreiten sie Krankheiten.
They spread disease,
Pest,
plague, leprosy, typhoid, cholera,
so
dysentery, etc.
Sie sind hinterlistig, feige und grausam und treten in großen Scharen auf.
And they appear in large groups.
Sie stellen unter den Tieren das Element der heimtückischen unterirdischen Zerstörung dar. Nicht anders als die Juden unter den Menschen.
Just like the Jews.
England. England will Krieg. Ich aber will Frieden mit England.
Die Engländer sind die Geschwister der Deutschen.
Ich habe gelesen, was Ihr Herr Churchill im Parlament gesagt hat. England will Krieg.
Herr Churchill. Mein Führer, Sie wissen überhaupt nichts über Herrn Churchill. Gar nicht. Herr Churchill ist ein gescheiterter Politiker. Und er trinkt zu viel Cognac. In England wird Churchill nicht ernst genommen. Im Parlament ist man der Meinung, dass Herr Churchill ein Clown ist.
Ein Clown? Streicher, hast du das gehört?
Na, warum, mein Führer?
Ein Clown. In England hält man Herrn Churchill für einen Clown.
Wie im Zirkus, mit einer roten Nase.
Mit einer roten Nase.
Mit einer roten Nase.
Die Engländer denken nicht an Krieg. Niemand in England will Krieg.
Wenn wir nur das Glauben kennten.
Sie können ganz sicher sein. Die Engländer bereiten sich nicht auf Krieg vor, überhaupt nicht.
Überhaupt nicht? Zum Beispiel, wie viele Flakstellungen gibt es um London?
3.
Nur 3?
Ja, 3. Ich bin ganz sicher.
3? Das ist interessant.
Dankeschön, mein Führer.
Meine Hingabe hat das deutsche Volk ganz und unverzichtbar. Verstehst du das?
Ich verstehe.
Schöne Haar. Einer aristokratischen englischen Lady.
She's a traitor.
Oh, nonsense, Philip. All the same, these English girls, they remember nothing of the war and they come here for the excitement of the uniforms. The black max, the headgear, like a bus conductor's with a cock stand. Nostalgia du bus conductor. And when the conductor drives about in a long black Mercedes with scarlet upholstery, of course he's irresistible. Oh, fine, healthy Rose. Do you know, I have a feeling Miss Unity Mitford may prove extremely useful to her.
Work for us, do you mean?
Not exactly. But her devotion to Herr Hitler may have the desired effect. It may make him look entirely ridiculous. There's no better recipe for peace than a burst of hearty laughter.
Don't you think it's getting a little late for peace?
No, too late, Philip. Never too late. Pass me some of that dung, will you, and see if you can't scrounge a bit more from the Poles next door.
Yes, sir.
You should take up gardening, you know, Philip. A rose has no desire to die for a cause or sacrifice itself for the future of mankind. Its sole ambition is to survive.
I honestly believe, sir, she's working for them.
Good,
Apparently, she told them last week we had only 3 anti-aircraft guns for the whole of London.
Sounds completely dotty.
Yes, sir.
So dotty, it's probably true.
Well, can't we do something to stop her, sir?
Good heavens no, my dear Philip. Lord bless my soul, we must do everything we can to make her carry on. The comedy, I feel sure, is about to begin. All the same, it might be just worthwhile to find out a little bit more about what your friend is saying to her friend. Might just perhaps keep half an eye on that, innit?
Dankeschön. Das sind unsere Freunde. Es ist eine Versammlung der Englisch-Deutschen Gesellschaft.
Die hier. Unsere Freunde. Wirklich?
Ja, sicher. Und Charlie Fortinbras, auf den könnten wir uns verlassen.
Ein verlässlicher Lord, also.
Nicht sein schrecklicher Bruder. Er ist fast ein Kommunist. Erledigen Sie ihn.
Was ist denn das für eine komische Gesellschaft?
Der Ball, da bist der Hand. Der wäre auf unserer Seite. Und der? Die sind eigentlich alle zuverlässig.
So viele Freunde haben wir unter diesen Leuten. In der weißesten Hand. Hm. Erstaunlich.
Philip.
Hello.
Come in.
Thank you.
Everything's changed. Unit is not here anymore. And we've lost Caroline Bowne.
You've lost her?
Well, she suddenly disappeared in the most mysterious fashion. We've got a dark lady with pince-nez now who makes us all stand to attention when she enters the club.
Oh, dear.
Do sit down.
Thank you.
I'm afraid it looks awfully plain and dreary now Unity's gone. She's, got a room now in the Ludwigstrasse, but she never seems to be there. Oh, and she's got a car now, too. Her father bought her an MG. Poor Philip. Were you terribly smitten with her?
Oh, I wouldn't say that. Not smitten, exactly.
Oh, she used to tell us you were frightfully keen.
Did she say that?
I think she was grateful. You never tried to do handies with her or anything. She couldn't stand that. She put a lot of men off, you know. I think they found her a little scary. I reckon she's met her match this time, though. Wouldn't you say so?
Ich möchte, dass Ihr König Eduard das weiß. Ich würde ihn sehr gern einmal treffen. Hier in Deutschland. Jederzeit. Ganz wie er wünscht.
Es würde ihm eine Ehre sein.
Stattdessen muss ich den Duce vom Bahnhof abholen. Herr Mussolini kommt anstolziert. Wie ein schlechter Opernsänger wird er mich anschreien. Mein Führer! Mein Schicksal fordert das Mittelmeer von Italien als mein persönliches Fußball! Man singt das Schicksal Italiens wie einer runtergekommene Tenor. Ihr Engländer habt eine unverzeihliche Dummheit gemacht, König Eduard ins Exil zu jagen. Eduard und ich, wir beide, wir hätten uns verständigen können. Verstehen Sie? Verstehen Sie das?
I brought you these, compliments over the twin.
I was worried you wasn't going to be up to eat
form of the hamburger was so clean you could have eaten your dinner off it. Not a bit like Kelly.
Oh, I have messages for you from all the sisters and old Nanny Hedges. You remember Nanny Hedges, don't you, dear?
Ah, was she the one with the feet?
The feet?
Yes.
Oh, dear, yes, I expect she was.
Oh,
she wasn't. She said, how
Bobo. Oh, she probably remembered Edith.
Look, will you tell the fellow to take these bloody birds? I seem to have been carrying them about for days.
Yes,
they won't need hanging.
Oh, never seen this.
I've got a new room in the Ludwigstrasse, so we'll have to hurry because I'd like to take her to meet a friend.
Oh,
come along quickly.
Well, I can tell you without a shadow of a doubt, no one in England wants war with Germany. We're a great deal more concerned about the Bolsheviks.
Bitte?
Mein Vater sagt, dass kein Engländer mit Deutschland Krieg führen will.
Außer Herrn Churchill.
Churchill. Churchill and the Jews. They're the only ones who want war with Germany.
Churchill und die Juden sind die einzigen in England, die Krieg mit Deutschland haben wollen.
My husband's a member of the House of Lords, Herr Hitler, and he can tell you that Mr. Churchill is not well thought of there. Not well thought of at all.
Man's an absolute sewer.
Of course, you have nothing like the House of Lords in Germany. You've done away with all that tiresome class distinction. I find that entirely admirable.
Oh, come on, Sydney. House of Lords is one of the cornerstones of the Christian religion.
Bitte?
Es ist nicht wichtig, es ist streiten sich über das Oberhaus.
I feel so ashamed that we can't speak German. Unity, of course, insisted on learning it. All young people today should learn German. Unity would never agree to learn French.
Quite right. Learn German. Only way to keep out the Bolsheviks.
Sie sagen, Sie werden sehr gern Deutsch lernen.
Tut mir außerordentlich leid, dass ich Ihre Sprache nicht kann. Ein Stückchen Schwarzwälder Kirschtorte, Frau Baronin. Sie ist sehr, sehr gut.
Oh, you don't happen to have such a thing as a little bread and butter?
No.
Oh, we bake our own bread, you know, in Swinbrook now. It's really awfully good and quite simple to do.
Was heißt das?
You simply mix together a lot of brown and white flour and make a sort of hole and then pour in milky water. And then you add the yeast and wait until it bubbles. You do have to knead it, of course. And add a good pinch of salt, and then knead it again, and bake it in a good hot oven for 20 minutes, and you can't buy bread like it in the shops.
Worüber spricht Ihre Mette, Frau Mutter?
Über Brot.
Über Brot? Brot!
Tell Herr Hitler about the station platform at Hamburg. Now, that's what really impressed me. You could have eaten your dinner off it.
Ich bitte um Vergebung wegen meiner mangelnden Sprachkenntnisse. Unity muss mein Dolmetscher werden.
What does Herr Hitler say about you, Bauer, dear?
He says he relies on me to interpret the English.
Well, that's thrilling. Isn't that thrilling?
Well done.
Brot!
Why are you sitting on my bench?
Yours?
Yes, of course. An Englishman built this garden out of nothing. Look. Here, where you walk, was once but only wood and marsh.
My God, your German's improving.
Thank you.
I suppose one might even put it in poetic terms and say, this place which, friend, you stand and contemplate, was once but swamp in nature's rudest state.
Why do you have to sneer at everything? The man who built this garden loved Germany, and so do I. What are you doing here, anyway?
Well, I was looking for you, as a matter of fact.
Well, why? Are you a spy?
Whatever makes you think that?
You're a British diplomat.
Ah, but only in the consular sense.
You have to rise. You want to get above yourself. You want to know what he thinks.
Do I?
Yes. Of course you do. Everyone does. The whole of Europe. Every night they wait by their wirelesses in fear and trembling, or elation. Because when he has a thought, just a thought, the world changes. You know that, don't you?
Yes, I suppose I do know that now. I don't imagine that's what he talks to you about, though, is it?
What?
The world changing. I imagine you to be, well.
What exactly?
I imagine you to be his relaxation. I suppose you go with the cream cakes and Wagner.
If only you knew. I interpret England for the Führer.
Oh, yes, of course you do. And how is England looking to him today?
He's furious.
Seems to be his natural state.
He's furious with us, having got rid of King Edward.
You mean the Duke of Windsor?
If that's what you like to call him. Come, Rebel. You see, he was relying on King Edward. He knew he understood the modern world. He had the qualities of a leader. The Führer felt the king could help restore the old comradeship between the British and German armies.
Oh, is that what they used to have?
You poor old Cambridge lefty, you know nothing about armies, do you? Gardens, for that matter.
Ich muss Ihnen mitteilen, dass sich Lady Mitford wiederholt mit einem Konsulatsbeamten im englischen Garten trifft. Ohne Zweifel hat sie ihm über ihre Gespräche mit dem Führer berichtet.
Lady Mitford.
So good of you to drop in, Herr Mortar.
Hi, Hitler.
My dear Herr Stryker, so good of you to drop in. I'm sure you'll find some people you know. I never know whether to say hail or good
fortune. Congratulations, Sir Hillary. You have your K at last.
Well, yes, more or less a bureaucratic formality.
You English are doing rather well, I must say. The Führer has already entertained the Duke and Duchess of Windsor.
I understand King George VI sent Herr Hitler a birthday telegram.
Yes, indeed. It was much appreciated.
Herr Hitler must be becoming quite a royalist.
I have to say I missed you both at the opera last night.
I'm sorry. There must be something missing in us. You know, I find it rather hard to take Wagner seriously. Perhaps I'm too English to understand it.
It comes very near as the dear Liebestod to the German heart.
I can imagine being in love with all sorts of inconvenient objects, but scarcely death. I mean, who wants to spend the afternoon in bed with some terminal disease?
That certainly is very amusing, but we must love each other's culture. You gave us Keats and Shakespeare, we give you Goethe and the Liebestod.
Grau, teure Freund, ist alle Theorie und Grund des Lebens.
Goldener Baum, genau.
I suppose it was the thoroughly inconvenient time I spent on the Somme in my youth that's put me off death for the rest of my life.
Sir Martin.
Sir Hilary Buchner, the K, the Christian of first names used.
Thank you, Huntingham. You know so much about the English aristocracy.
Please forgive me, this dear old Lady Spurbright. I must have a word with her, please. Spurbright!
May I have just one word with you, Sir Hilary? It is important. important for British representation in Munich. I'm sure you'll agree that we can trust each other. Is it so?
Well, I hope it is, whenever possible.
Well, I must ask you then. Who's Lady Mitford?
Ah, an enthusiastic admirer of your Führer. I'm sure you know.
And, as I also know, someone closely in touch with a British consular official.
I'm sure she has a lot of friends in the English community.
An official whom she meets in the mornings in the English gardens. To whom she tells details of the Führer's conversations.
It must be very fascinating for him, whoever he may be.
If these reports continue, we may have to declare Lady Mitford absolute.
Oh, surely not. Surely the point of Miss Mitford, perhaps the only point of Miss Mitford, is that she is persona very much grander indeed. Is that not so, Herr Bruckner?
I have said what I thought needed to be said, Sir Hilary. I do not think I need to repeat it.
Philip, dear boy.
Yes, sir.
I have a feeling that they're beginning to get the joke.
In England has no idea of the Jewish danger. The Jews say Herr Hitler wants war because they want to turn England against Germany.
But doesn't Herr Hitler want war?
Of course Herr Hitler doesn't want war. In fact, Herr Hitler is the only man who can bring us peace because he understands the English and he wants our friendship. He has a genius for achieving the impossible. And if he does bring peace, he should be deified. By that, I mean he should be a god.
Thank you, Miss Mitford.
Thank you.
Yes, of course. Yes, I understand. The Foreign Office want to arrange a final meeting here in Munich. Prime Minister's prepared to fly over.
All in the cause of peace.
My father had a gardener called Harry Burns. He could perform miracles with a grafting knife. He knew considerably more about roses than any of your experts at Kew. The only two places Harry'd been to were our little village in Dorset and a rather flat, depressing area of northern France. He came out to the war as my servant. He hadn't been there 12 days before I had the task of picking him off the barbed wire, or what was left of him. Never thought I'd hear the word peace spat out like an obscenity.
What is the point of peace, sir, without some sort of justice?
Oh, injustice, my dear Philip, is as old as the Garden of Eden. I always thought that that was an utterly ridiculous penalty for eating an apple. God does overreact sometimes. No, the fact of the matter is that injustice has existed since the beginning of time. We don't have to have gardeners reduced to mincemeat on barbed wire because of it.
No doubt Miss Mitford will be delighted. She told reporters last week that if Hitler makes peace, he should be deified.
Deified?
Yes.
Oh, that is magnificent. My dear Philip, you couldn't have hoped for anything better. This girl will do more for your justice than any of the popular fronts or left-wing organizations you've ever subscribed to. Do you know what she's done? She has made the glorified bus conductors look ridiculous. My God. Bruckner seems to have discovered our secret weapon.
I must tell you, I feel that in some way your mission has been a failure. You were to civilize us a little, weren't you? Bring a sense of style. A touch of the English gentleman to our great leader.
Very great to have to tell you that it has failed. Failed dismally. The Führer has his destiny, of course. I represent him to the world as Napoleon, as Charlemagne, as François Premier. What can I do? What can either of us do? When he surrounds himself with cronies whose only sense of style is to fill their bellies with schnapps and vomit on the floor of some provincial beer keller. Yeah. And last they played for the Führer. Streicher sat on the Burkhard sofa and made levatory jokes, and Bruckner is no better. Bruckner dislikes you, I must say. He thinks you are a spy.
Oh, really? Why does he think that, do you suppose?
I suppose because you have a certain breeding. And to regard a Führer Wilhelm Bruckner, all breeding is suspect. How boring it would be, I tell him, if I played your beloved Liebestod only on the white keys. We need the black notes too, you know. They are the salt and the egg of our existence. The good life, the civilized life, it's not just black and white. It's very subtle and beautiful shades of gray. You not agree with me, my dear?
He cannot see it. The gang of provincial roughnecks who fawn on him will not let him see it.
They crowd around him, my dear. We, who might bring him a breath of civilization, are forced into the background. So, when he gets to Paris, to London, and New York, he will not be Charlemagne, I'm afraid. He will not be Napoleon. He will be a failed art student with a genius for politics and an appalling taste in France.
Well, if you think that, you shouldn't be working for him, should you?
Of course. Of course, we must go on working for him. Otherwise, he'd be surrounded by a bunch of yes men, just like a bloody Hollywood producer.
You should know, shouldn't you?
What? So, I don't understand. What should I know?
About Hollywood producers. He told me, the leader told me, that when he was fighting in the trenches, that's when you were living in America.
Yes. And having a far harder time, with all due respect to those who died, having my windows broken as an enemy alien, being insulted every day. We Germans must not be aliens anymore. We are equal citizens of the culture of the West.
Langsam.
Heil Hitler.
Was du da oben?
Dr. Anstrenger.
Aha. Jetzt verstehe ich.
Of course. I mean, there must be the most appalling tenants. So careless about getting their windows broken. Oh. Everything. Leda has given me everything I ever wanted.
A flat in the Agnesstrasse?
Exactly. Oh, it's so big. Big, light and full of sunshine. Oh, look, Annie, that's a marvellous place for Hannibal crossing the Alps.
Guten Morgen.
The bedroom's marvellous. I'm going to have two huge swastika flag trees right over the bed. Oh, I have to get rid of these curtains.
Terrifically nouveau jour, aren't they?
You had seen
that dreadful old sofa, but once we've cleared everything out...
Oh, look, Emma, there's even a little alcove of Rachula. We can have parties here, can't we? And peace in our time.
I might even ask the sisters to stop. Certainly Diana. Yes, I'll ask them when I go over at Christmas.
Annie! Do you know what? seen this wet, seen this dry. I do believe that this is somewhere where I could actually be happy.
The matter will be decided next month at a special inquiry held by the Board of Trade.
Yes, little lady.
The Labour Party has announced that it would hold a rally in Hyde Park today. The theme will be Save Peace, Save Spain. The Commissioner of Police for the Metropolis said this morning that a firm line will be taken with any troublemakers.
Quite right.
Cricket. To aid the legitimate forces of enlightenment now fighting in Spain.
Down with the communists! Yes.
Words are not enough. We can and must supply the Republican forces with munitions.
I'll have that badge on.
The war,
sir. Dad, give me that.
The war now being fought in Spain casts long shadows across Europe.
Filthy comet.
It crystallizes the central issues of our age.
Give me the badge.
The survival of civilization itself could be at stake if the fascist forces win in Spain.
All of you.
What type of badge was it exactly?
It was just a black swastika on a pink and white background. I hit the man who tore it off.
Williams, News Chronicle. Well, if you must wear a Nazi badge at an arms for Spain rally, you can't complain.
Of course I'm complaining. They said insulting things. They yelled, and I think they wanted to chuck me in the serpentine. I was kicked quite a lot. And then a woman said something about Herr Hitler. So I hit her too. I only got a few kicks and bruises. Luckily, the police came to my rescue.
And what is your friend Herr Hitler going to have to say about all this?
He wouldn't like a woman to get into this sort of scrimmage.
Huh? Why not?
He wouldn't think it madly ladylike.
Long agony in a lift shaft, slowly crushed to death by lift.
Ja?
Ich möchte gern mit dem Führer sprechen.
Bitte?
Ich bin soeben aus England zurückgekommen. Ich möchte gern mit dem Führer sprechen.
Lady Mitford, Sie will mit dem Führer sprechen.
Ach, Lady Mitford.
Herr Bruckner, Sie sind es nicht wahr?
Es tut mir leid, aber es ist zurzeit leider nicht möglich.
Herr Bruckner, wo ist der Führer? Ich habe gelesen, dass er in München ist.
Es tut mir sehr leid, Lady Mitford, aber...
Sie Hanfstengel. He's in Switzerland.
Switzerland?
They sent him up in an aeroplane. It seems the crew had orders to push him out. Somewhere over the Alps. Poor old Putzi. He could have started an avalanche. Well, anyway, he managed to persuade them. They only had orders to frighten him. You know what a wonderful talker Putzi is. So they've let him down gently on neutral territory. Pity. You might miss him.
It's not Putzi I miss, thank you. Oh, I've only seen the Führer once since I've been here. And that was for 5 minutes at the opera with a crowd of people. That arch sewer, Bruckner, keeps refusing to put me through. Oh, I don't know where I am anymore.
Is this where you keep the Valkyrie?
Oh, no, I couldn't possibly. The Führer would see it in my eyes.
Unity.
I wonder where all my friends disappeared to.
I need your help, desperately. You must tell your friend, the one that counts. The one with the sweet little Mac and the Charlie Chaplin moustache.
Can you be careful?
Oh, yes, that's right. I should be careful, shouldn't I? Particularly after what your friend's done to my friend. Oh. Lothar. My beautiful Lothar. Some swine. Some heavy party number Lothar refused to sleep with us, put it about that he's got a Jewish grandmother. The most Aryan hair and the brownish shirts imaginable. And I give you my word of honor, darling, he's not even circumcised.
Tony, will you be quiet?
I won't be quiet until you promise you'll find him for me. Sorry. It's ridiculous. I'm in love. You don't know about that, do you?
It's the law to decide if your friend's Jewish or not. He'll be treated perfectly fairly.
He just vanished. He goes to a camp.
Oh, Tony. Tony, if he's Jewish, a camp will do him good. Best thing for him.
You're mad, aren't you? You're stark, raving mad. You and your friend. Your famous friend. You know what I bet? I bet you don't even do anything. All that bloody showing off and grandeur, and you didn't do a thing, either of you. When are you going to stop talking rubbish and get down some decent sex and that dear little loveliness in your Anjestrasse? Why don't you try getting up to something it might be worth kicking the Jews out for?
I don't know, then.
Ah, Gross and Cognac, thank you very much, if it's not too much trouble.
It won't be any trouble at all, Albertini, to have you thrown out of the osteria.
Oh, no. We're leaving anyway.
Oh, please, Lucia, I need your help. Please, please.
I'll give you some advice. You should leave Germany, Tony. You don't belong here.
Oh, I don't belong in the nightmare. That should be some sort of consolation. The trouble is, I do. Well, they've got Lothar. This is where I bloody well belong.
Come along, my dear. This restaurant seems to have gone down in the world.
Oh, please. Bastards.
Up all night.
I couldn't sleep either.
I set myself the task of casting the leader's horoscope. It's very dark. As I was writing with the charts, I kept on thinking of that Tristan music that poor Putzi used to play to him. I hope I've miscalculated. The signs lead to death.
That's absolutely ridiculous.
Of course.
Anyway, the leader doesn't follow your little horoscopes. He makes his own future.
A man who can tear up the chart of heaven as though it was the Treaty of Versailles.
I sincerely hope you're right. Otherwise, we all go with him. The whole people sighing for death at Tristan's castle. I'm being romantic.
You're being ridiculous.
And I'm neglecting a beautiful guest.
I told you I couldn't sleep. It's the rotten dream. I've had it since nursery at Swinbrook. Nasty ladies.
What kind of a dream?
I'm in this narrow lane with high, high hedges on each side, so there's no escape. And this huge steamroller is coming straight at me. Absolutely nothing I can do to stop it.
Then where do the nasty ladies come in?
They're driving the steamroller. They're very, very objectionable and huge. They're all in black, with nanny boots and straw bonnets or black boaters. They're working various wheels and levers to drive the steamroller straight at me. They've come back in force now. Nasty ladies.
The case is serious.
Yes, isn't it?
But I have a cure.
I know, Janosch, you always have a cure for everything. We must be mad. He's speaking from the sports blast at 11:30. Get the wirelesses. All the wirelesses in the house, we will give him the most enormous audience. Ernst! Alle Ruhm von dem Fenger im Schloss. Wie stellen Sie nach draußen?
Ist das in Ordnung, Herr Graf?
Ja, mach nur ernst.
Sie richtet das Wort.
Ja,
ist bewiesen worden. Erstens, durch die Abstimmung in Österreich. Ein glühendes Bekenntnis wurde damals abgelegt. Ein Bekenntnis, wie die andere Welt sich das sicher nicht erhofft hatte.
Die Fahne hoch!
Allein, wir haben es dann ja erlebt. Für Demokratien ist in dem Augenblick Volksabstimmung überflüssig oder sogar verderblich, indem sie nicht zu dem Resultat führt, dass sich die Demokratien erhoffen. Trotzdem, dieses Problem wurde gelöst. Zum Glück des ganzen großen deutschen Volkes. Und es steht nun vor uns, das letzte Problem, das gelöst werden muss und gelöst werden wird.
Would it be unseemly to suggest that you only agreed because of what that little pansy said about you in the restaurant? Anyway, it didn't work, did it? The cure didn't work. I'm sorry.
I'm afraid I've ruined your reputation.
Oh, don't worry, my dear. I'm usually very discreet about my failures. Not that I've ever had such an experience before. What's to become of us?
Well, if you don't know all those damned horoscopes, who does?
I don't suppose we shall be visiting Germany again for some time.
Sure you'll miss it.
Yeah, at Halifax last night on the wireless. We stand by our guarantee to Poland. I'm afraid this time Herr Hitler has come too far.
I find it rather difficult to distinguish it from all the other times.
A treaty obligation.
Good heavens, have we started thinking about those?
Such a tragedy. We could have united with Germany, we'd have been irresistible. As it is, I'm afraid the only gainers will be our red friends in the East. No, there's They're getting away from it this time. Herr Hitler has made a bad miscalculation.
So have I. You, Hitler?
I thought the world would never take seriously anything Miss Unity Mitford thought serious. It seems that I was entirely wrong. Oh, you know Colindale, of course, aching to get into the army, flat feet and all.
Very kind, sir. Sir Arnold.
Well, my boy, awkward sort of time to be born, eh?
Oh, I don't know, sir. I think things show signs of improving.
Well, that's the spirit then, isn't it? And I've no doubt you'll do your bit exactly as your father did in the trenches, and I've got no sort of doubt about what the outcome will be. Our old country's always been at its best when its back is to the wall. And thank you. I'm prepared to face the coming struggle in good heart. What do you say, Harry?
Oh, yes, of course. Nothing reconciles you to the onset of war like being too old for military service.
Last war was awful. I felt terribly sorry for all those poor women who lost their husbands in France.
Did you? I felt a bit sorry for the husbands as well.
Do you really think there's going to be a war?
I'm afraid so, my dear. We women will just have to be terribly brave about it.
But why now?
It seems Sir Arnold has decided that the time has come.
Shame. Just when we got the roses established.
Oh, try not to worry too much, my dear. We'll do our best to evacuate the roses and, of course, our scattered citizens. It's me your job, Philip.
What's that, sir?
Search the tea shops, peer under the Duras and the Alte Pinakothek. Drag the beer cellars, scour the forest. Prise the wayward debutante away from the belligerent bus conductor. Send the straying English home.
Get everyone back on the right side of the line before the whistle blows, eh, Hillary?
I don't know what our dear old country would do without the sporting metaphor. My day to be blown to bits in a muddy ditch in northern France was known as keeping a straight bat. Facing the bowling.
About the Mitford girl, sir.
Hmm?
Do you want her rounded up as well?
Oh, yes. Yes, I can't think of any use here anymore. Not to the home team. All the visitors.
I've been instructed to call on you.
Instructed?
Yes. By the consul. To warn you. The situation is getting extremely serious. The British are all leaving Munich, and the consul strongly advises you to go too.
Go? Where should I go?
Home.
Where do you think that is?
Well, I imagine at Swinbrook with your family.
No. Here is home. Near the leader is my home.
I must warn you that after tomorrow, you no longer have the protection of His Majesty's government.
I have the protection of the leader. I think that might be much better, don't you?
You ask me? No, I don't.
Are you going to fight? Are you?
If I have to.
You won't be much good at it, will you? He'll probably make you a sergeant in army education. How heroic. I can do more good here. I shall ask the leader to be merciful to our people.
Oh, don't be so dramatic, for God's sake. Just go home. As though you're acting in a play you can't even understand.
You can thank the consul very much for his message. As for leaving Munich, I do not contemplate it.
You're being so childish. Just like an Englishman I met the other day at the Adler Hotel, who said he's not leaving Munich until next week because he's got tickets for Lern.
Oh, he sounds a sensible chap. I must get to know him. Heil Hitler!
Goodbye.
wieder, mein Führer.
Ich muss mit Ihnen sprechen.
Das geht zu weit, Fräulein Mitford.
Ich muss mit Ihnen sprechen.
Wir haben nichts zu besprechen, mein Kind. Geh nach Hause und sag deinen aristokratischen Freunden, wenn sie Krieg mit uns spielen wollen, es wird uns ein Vergnügen sein. Mach, dass du nach England kommst, du dummes Kerl. Vorwärts!
Fräulein, was ist der Krieg?
Die Verfremdete meiner Verbundenheit mit dem deutschen Volk!
Tragedy. It's what Nanny Hedges says in her letter. I can't think of you as tragic. You had so much life now, so much energy. You did your best. You all understand that. Barb says that to everyone now. Barb did her level best. You've got to hand it to her. She did her best to get peace and stop the communists. We're all behind you in that. You do know, don't you? We're all behind you now. What it means, doesn't it, Bert, is that you're really with us. Now, for always. Back. You of all the sisters. Our very own Bobo, brought home through Switzerland in the middle of the war. But you'll never leave us again. Never. Will you, darling? What I keep saying to Farr, what I'll never get over is that in spite of the war and all the troubles, Herr Hitler paid for all those doctor's bills. That was a gesture, wasn't it? And I think extremely generous. Go on, Farr, play the music. You like music, don't you? You're always such a happy person. So full of fun all the time. So kind-hearted. That's what they don't understand, these stupid people in the newspapers. They want to have you shut away and taken from us. They won't succeed, Bert, I promise you that. They'll never succeed. Be with us always. Don't you, darling? And we're so proud of you. You remember, don't you, when you took us to have tea with Herr Hitler? We're both so proud of you then. I must say this for Herr Hitler. What I saw of him, he always had such perfect manners.
Oh!
Mark!